May I ask who's calling? Yes, ma'am. This is John Dixon.
How you doing, man?
No, I just wasn't as sure of the number. That was like 2 or 3 years ago? Yes, ma'am.
Wow.
Wow. No, I'm not with Luke Lynn anymore. Yeah, not really, but it's. I don't believe so. I already told the truth, yeah. Okay. 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 Probably not. I am in New Orleans, yes. I live in Mid-City. I live at 426 South Clark Street. Seven zero one one nine. Yeah. Oh, that's cool. Yes, ma'am. I'm technically 24/7 on call, but most of the time I work, 6 a.m. to 2. Or I'll mostly work days, but there are some events where I'm called at, in the middle of the night, which I work for a company called Intertek. I'm a cargo surveyor. If you need me, you're gonna have to give me as much time as possible. If you need me, I'm gonna need as much heads up as possible so that I can let Intertek know. I guess that depends on how far you find out. I mean, as much time as possible. A month would be, yes. At least a couple weeks would be preferred. Do I think I should have warned her? I guess I could have warned her, but I mean, she was handling her own business, and I was handling my business.
I was only a matter, my, what I was doing was only a matter of a minute, less than a minute, you know, like 20 seconds to change a mat out. And she did see me. Correct. Like I said, I remembered her going in there to argue some ticket or something about her son. And I moved my car, my cart was out to the side. She was there. I quickly moved the top or the mat, and in a matter of a second, she ran out the door like she was mad at what they said to her. You know, like, oh no, ma'am, your son needs to come and take care of this or something along those lines. And she instantly like stormed out. Such a quick, like, if she would have asked me, like, oh, can I go? Or, you know what I mean? If she would have acknowledged that, hey, there's something going on here, I would have just said, I would have changed the map. You know what I mean? Like, yeah, that's absolutely not. Correct. Like I said, this whole instance, mind you, this was 2 years ago, but this whole instance happened in a matter of, you know, from the time I walked in, from the time she walked out, maybe a minute and a half to 2 minutes, not even. It was such a quick instance. Why? Who's your client? Scott Burke? I have. Okay. Okay. Here. I understand. In all honesty, I love Loop. I miss Loop. If they offered me a job right now, I'd go back to them in a heartbeat. But I did crash. I got into two wrecks in a matter of less than 6 months. So they couldn't insure me after that. They did offer me another position in the plant, but it was making, you know, it wasn't making the type of money that I could do. So unfortunately, we parted ways. No bad blood. But, I mean, I'm sure Scott's not happy that I crashed his trucks twice. And it wasn't me crashing them, it was just... Because, like I said, honestly, I love them. They're a good company, you know, and they really did a lot for them. I don't know. If I did, they would know at Loop. Because I don't have that phone anymore, you know. No. At least the event that we're speaking of, I remember clearly that they pressure washed the outside either that day or the day before. They were actually still building, you know, the, I don't remember, you know, the police station in Gretna? They were actually building it at that point, so I think they were washing it because, you know, there was so much debris or dirt, you know, it just was dirtier in that area, you know, than correct. So, a little bit, yeah. Because those pressure washers work, they're such fast water that even a crack, it'll find a way to shoot water in that crack. Or, you know, if someone didn't shut the door all the way, or, you know. Yes, ma'am. About this instance, correct. Those three, yes. Scott, Gretna PD, and you. So, no, no. I mean, I considered myself a pro. Like, I was definitely, I don't know, it's just laying down mats, so it's nothing big, but I had, like, a routine, a tight routine. It was almost fun. I miss that type of, right, I miss that. I don't have that with this job. Yes, but I was working that route for maybe 9 months. So I had those guys as customers for about 9 months, and then I became the Baton Rouge driver. So I actually got promoted to a bigger route. At that location? Not that I can recall. Nothing, and if so, nothing more than the average, you know, they just mopped or they put a sign up or nothing that I can really remember. That day was actually, like, completely saturated. I mean, I haven't changed a mat in 8 months, but I mean, you're supposed to normally, like, lay it down, just keep it down until you can actually change it, but in that instance, I had my cart right next to me, so I didn't think to lay it back down for the half a second it would take me to grab the next mat. Well, no, I mean, if it was a dry floor, I'd do the same thing. I would pick up the mat, fold it, put it on my cart, and then I would drop the fresh mat. Well, I let them know. I definitely let the people at the front door know, but, you know, right, when you're out in the truck for 12 to 15 hours, you can't wait for a maintenance guy to come and mop up your floor. So, it's, I guess in a perfect world, yes, you'd wait there and wait for someone to come mop it up, then change the mat, but, you know, you gotta do what you gotta do sometimes.
out the sides or anything like that. But when I lifted the mat, there was some wetness. It's hard to explain. It wasn't like the mat was intentionally sprayed down or anything like that. It just damp residue, water residue. If I can remember correctly, it was probably like a 3x5 or a 4x6 mat. So there's probably like, maybe a foot, maybe a little bit more mark of water, because it's hard to explain. When you put water on the ground and you squish it under a flat surface, it gets right. So I don't know how to really describe that, but yeah. Beautiful. Thank you so much. Yes, if possible, like I said, this job is it's on call 24/7. So the more warning I have, the better chance I'm able to get to where I need to go. Not a problem. Have a great day.
Bye. Bye. Damn it.